All right. Thank you all for being here tonight. Welcome to WOW. My name is Dave Troxell. I'm the local general manager for our internet and video and phone services in Columbus Valley and Auburn. This is our humble abode, and Pam had approached us earlier on about having this graduation ceremony here. The price was right? We got the price right, so everything was good. And I've had the opportunity and really the blessing to work with these students and these scholars through Pam's program over the past year and gotten to know a lot of these folks, and it's a great team. I don't know if you fully realize what is going on here, but you are developing the future broadcasters and anchor people for whether it's CNN, NBC, CBS, ABC, Fox, I don't care. This is the group, and they're really, really good at what they do. They take a lot and a lot of time to set their interviews up right. They do their homework, and they've learned so much this year. Isn't it neat to see them from the very beginning when they're kind of nervous and they're sharing a little bit about themselves, and then all of a sudden they got you on the spot. They want to know, what did you know and when did you know it? And they're asking you questions like that. They're good. I mean, they really are, and it's been a lot of fun. So tonight is about you. And to honor what you've done, and we're so proud to have you here. So that's my little spiel. I get the pleasure and privilege to turn this over to Miss Pam now. Here you go.
Thank you so much. Let's give Mr. Dave a hand. It's a privilege and an honor to be able to teach your children. It's because of what you do at home, it's made my job very easy. But this is out of all of my career, this is one of my most stellar moments, is to do a graduation for children and to teach children. And I must say, I'm having a hard, hard time because I'm going to miss each and every one of you so much. But I do plan very much to keep up with you. And with that being said, I'm going to let my mother, who is the co-pastor of Move of God Ministries, she's going to be your mistress of ceremony, and she's going to give us the prayer. Co-pastor Mommy. Don't I look like her?
Right. We come to have a good time for this graduation. I ask that you bow your heads, please. Oh, Heavenly Gracious Father, we thank you for being the main guest here on tonight. And Father, we thank you for blessing us with these many different gifts and talents that we have in this place on tonight. We ask that you bless each and every one. And Father, we just love you, and we ask that you continually to look over with Pam. And Father, we thank you how you just love us. And thank you so much for what all you have done for each and every one that is here on tonight. Thank you for the parents. Thank you for the children. Thank you for WOW. We just want to thank you for unity with Pam. And Lord, we give you all honor and praise. Amen. 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 And now we will have a welcome. He did that already. Yes. So everybody feel welcome. I know that they are welcome. All right. So special moments. All right. Dr. Precious Evans of Wesley Heights Elementary School. Oh, she's not here. Amen. So, okay. I thought that for a minute I was in church. Y'all heard me say amen, didn't you? Amen. Oh, it's just in me. That's all. It's just in me. All right. Media specialist, Mary Walker. All right. Thank you.
Staying 4 minutes. I will have no trouble staying under 4 minutes, but I do want to thank Pam and her team and all of the teachers that came and all of the people that came to be interviewed to let the children practice interviewing and learn how. This has been a very fine experience for our children at Wesley Heights Elementary, and it's something that you don't often get a chance to do, but it gives the students a way to put what they're learning in the classroom to use. They learn about writing, they learn about speaking, They learn all kinds of things that they are going to use as they get older and older. And it's been a real pleasure working with all these children. I just love it in the morning when they come bouncing in. Thank you.
Thank you all so much for coming on tonight. I am elated to be acquainted with Unity with Pam. We have a history already because my parents and her parents are acquainted. They're both pastors and the family. So we already have a relationship. But when she came to me and talked with me about her vision, to me, and I will go on and say it because I'm not a different type person. It was just a blessing. It was just a blessing to already know that we already have a wonderful bond and relationship in our families, and that she is willing to come and bring her team to Wesley Heights Elementary School and bless us and teach us and these awesome scholars that I just get so full about on a daily basis, because they are fantastic, as you can very well see. The proof is right here. And I say to you, thank you, thank you. And I'm getting ready to have my seat momentarily. I have three events that I am supposed to attend on tonight. But I want to give this plug. She has brought so many people to us at Wesley Heights, and the community is not aware of it. We need to get out there and let them know all that she's doing for our community. And it is wonderful. And we thank you and we bless you for that. First, my awesome teachers, you have to stand, because the reason why the scholars are like they are is because of the amazing parents that we have and the wonderful teachers. So please stand. You teach these scholars. Miss Lynn. Stand, Miss Hurley. My outstanding academic coach, Miss Bentley. I have our wonderful parent liaison here. That's you, Miss Claudia Woods. Stand up. And you've already heard from our great media specialist. Stand up, please, Miss Mary Jean Walker. And I know that you're going to acknowledge the parents. Parents, we thank you. You are amazing. You allow the scholars to stay after school on Thursdays, and we thank you so much, because without you and your support, we would not be able to do this, and we thank you for that.
We thank Mr. Dave also. Yeah. Hey. Mm-hmm. And now we will have remarks from the from Unity with Pam teachers. Mr. Ty Manns and Greg Grice.
Thank you. I'm Ty Manns. And I just want to say thank Wow and Dr. Evans, your parents, Pam, for giving me the opportunity to come a few nights, a few days throughout the week and share my passion with you young guys, and that's filmmaking and film writing. I've been in that business for a long time, and it gave me a chance to really just share with them. Well, Pam told me I only had a few minutes, so I'm going to talk fast, so you're going to have to keep up, okay? And she said that I was supposed to talk about how much fun I had, but realistically, we all had fun. I want to leave a few things on you, though, that got me where I am today, and I want you to put them in your kit bags, okay? So three things and a promise, all right? First thing you have to do to get where you want to be in life, and I don't care whether you're a filmmaker, media, this line, whatever it is, you got to respect your mom and dads. Amen. If you don't have respect for your parents, it's going to be hard for you to respect yourselves. You understand that? Your mom and dads, no one will love you like they will. No one. You have a lot of people in your life. But your mothers and your fathers, your grandparents, your relatives are going to love you more than anybody in this world. And you have to respect them. Okay? Next thing you have to do is you have to respect your educators. Amen. That's teachers, coaches, pastors. Because you will spend a lot of time of your young life, up to at least 18 years of age, with these individuals. You will. We have to put you on school buses in the morning. We have to trust teachers to take care of you and educate you. You spend the evenings and weekends with coaches if you're in a sport. And you spend Sundays with a pastor trying to help you set your moral compass. You understand that? You have to respect these people. They're there for a reason. They're here to help us. They and my age, they're still helping me. You understand that? Last thing in the respect part is you have to respect yourself. None of that matters if you don't have respect for yourself. Okay? Because as you grow older, the gentleman in the film said it right. He said, you're young people. You're not young. You're not boys and girls. You're young women, young men. If you don't respect yourself, nobody else will. You have to know as you get older, you're going to learn right from wrong. And it won't be the cool kid down the hallway telling you what's right from wrong. It won't be the guy with the fancy car, pocket full of money. It have to be you. If you've respected your parents, you respect your educators, now you respect yourself. When you get in a situation when you say to yourself, you know what, this just don't feel right, walk away. You'll be able to do that because you have respect for yourself. You won't want to hurt yourself. You won't want to hurt your educators. You won't want to hurt your parents. Finally, I want you to make a promise that you will always keep education as a high priority in your life. My daughter just graduated from grad school at Michigan State last Friday. Master's degree in language. Language science, no less. She speaks 5 languages. Now, she's going to come home in a couple weeks, talk to me over the summer. I won't understand a thing she's saying. I'll nod a lot, shake my head, make all kinds of weird faces, but I'll believe everything that she's saying. But it was at the graduation ceremony, and Red has pointed me out, and this is my last one. It was at the graduation ceremony, she came up to me, she gave me a big hug. She said, are you proud of me? I said, why would you even ask that question? She said, because I remember years ago when you adopted me, you gave me the speech about the 3 respects and the 1 promise. Amen. And she said that I remember you saying, don't ever give your parents just 1 thing to be proud of you. Look. When you look back there and you see all these family members and friends here, they're proud tonight. Give them another opportunity at high school graduation. Give them another opportunity at college graduation. And then you can be a filmmaker or anything else you want to do in this life. You got it? Promise me. Everybody got it? All right. I hope to see you guys down the road as we continue these classes somewhere along the line. Thank you, Pam. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, parents.
Thank you so much. And now we will have, I'm sorry.
Oh, great. Oh.
Only because I didn't reach for the mic. Okay, I'm not going to say very much other than that these young men and women really inspired me a whole lot. I know there were some days when I was feeling kind of down, hurting, aching, because I'm an old broke up man. But when I come around them, you know, I'd be uplifted. My spirits would be uplifted. I'd be energized, and I'd be able to do what I wanted to do and needed to do with you all, and that was to share what knowledge and experience that I have in the area of photography, but not just photography. Photography, videography, those are just tools or resources that you use to help you to be able to get through life. You can apply what you've learned in life overall. I'm going to cut it short, but I want to say that I wish each and every one of you the very best, and I know that you will achieve all and more than you ever imagined as you move forward in the years ahead. You've shown it. You all are disciplined. You all are respectful. You all show honor, you know, and that's great. Because there's a lot of people, a lot of young people, they don't do that. So somewhere, someone, and we know who those someones were, you know, parents and grandparents, aunts and uncles, have taught you all to value your life and the people who love you and share life with you. If I could, real quick, ask Vijay to come up and also ask, where'd she go? Where'd Ms. Wilson go? Oh, to come up, please. Surprise Pam. Surprise Pam.
Would all the students please stand?
DJ, where's BJ? There you go.
Ms. Pam, would you please step forward? On behalf of the broadcast team, we would like to thank all of our instructors. And we would like to present Ms. Pam with a token of our gratitude. Years from now, it will not matter what kind of house you live in, how much money you had, or what your clothes were like, but the world may be a little better because you made a difference in a child's life.
Aww. Oh, you know I like to eat. You gotta come forward. That means Daddy gotta run the camera for you. About time my son get on camera. I can't never accomplish this. Mr. Dane, we're going over your time.
Oh no.
Thank you, Al.
I'm not used to this.
To Mrs. Pam Hovey, Mr. David Beers, Mr. Greg Rice, and Mr. Alex Thompson, the Wesley Heights Elementary School 2014 broadcast team would like to present you with a small token of our appreciation, your hard work and dedication to us.
Thank you.
Thank you for your time and dedication. WHES 2014 portrait.
Pam Hovey.
Oh, wow. I'll put a big girl picture in there. Oh, isn't that sweet? See what happens when you don't stay behind the scene. Okay, y'all, it's time for y'all possessional. So y'all will go out and then Mr. Brian Roberts will start the music up. Y'all will go out and come back around. Miss Joseph, just take them around and the music will start up. And Miss Roz Durden will do the presenting. From me, West Baker, let's give her a hand. And Mr. Day, we put the medals around their neck.
That's good.
And her name, I can sit down.
You are loved. You won't forget who you are either.
No, I won't.
Before our scholars enter, I would just like to say a few things. I think the word wow perfectly describes what we've seen today. Not only the perfect interviews, but just everything that's been said and done. The word wow actually describes it all. And we're just so grateful and so thankful for what these scholars have done. And I know you are so proud. Parents, friends, Pam and others, anyone who has had something to do with this, you cannot help but be very, very, very proud of what you witnessed, not only today. These scholars are our tomorrow leaders. Let's give them a round of applause before they start coming out. And also, as we commend these wonderful, great scholars, I don't want to fail to acknowledge Pam. Pam was given a vision. She wrote the vision, she made it plain, and she implemented the vision. So I thank God for what she has done. I know it hasn't been easy. I've talked to Pam about this program several times. It's been very difficult, but she persisted, she pressed on, and today we see the fruits of her labor. So let's give her a big hand. As we call the scholars' names, they will come forth to receive their certificate. Before Jamia comes forth, I would just like to read the certificate. It reads, Certificate of Graduation. Wherefore, by diligent effort and determination, it is hereby recognized that the scholar's name has successfully completed participation in Unity with Pam broadcast team, as presented by Unity with Pam TV show, and is signed May the 6th, 2014, Pam Hovey. Our first scholar, Jamia Foster. Let's give her a great hand of applause. Our next scholar is Adrian Brown. I think Adrian likes to be called Rudy. Let's congratulate her. Congratulations. Our next scholar is Ronnie Joseph III. Let's give Ronnie a big hand of applause. Congratulations, Ronnie. Our next scholar is Kyle Jackson. Let's give Kyle a big hand of applause. Congratulations, Kyle. Our next scholar is Miles Brazemore. I'm sorry, Miles. Congratulations. Miles Davis. Our next scholar is Kaliana Pemixsad. Let's give Kaliana a big hand of applause. Congratulations, Kaliana. Our next scholar is Tyree Anderson. Let's give Tyree a big hand. Our last scholar, but certainly not least, is Vincent Jones II, the boss. Congratulations. Again, we congratulate all of our scholars. They've done a magnificent job. Thank you very much.
Let's get a shot. Let's all of us get a shot.
we're going to have my father to give us the benediction. We've got snacks in the back. The cake, Miss Joseph provided it for us. Also, we're going to be starting another tutorial program. Miss Joseph, I'm sorry about that, Miss Wilson. She provided it for us. Also, we're going to be partnering with Tears, Inc. We'll be starting another school tutorial program July the 14th. So once we implement this program in, we see how the children are. We would love for these children to come and mentor our next set. So give us some time to implement in our next school. But we'll be starting up another school July the 14th. We want to thank Tears for allowing us to partner with them. Of course, my mentor who started me out, Mr. Virgil Thompson, who is Alex Thompson's father, WYBU, give a hand. My sound man, Mr. Brian Roberts. The money man, Mr. David Veers. My personal photographer, Mr. Greg Grice. I say anytime you get a man that makes a big woman look good in a photo, give him a check. And of course, one of my sponsors is here, Pastor Lowell Clyde, Seeds of Faith, Tree of Life. And my parents. Of course, pastor and co-pastor, Will A. Willis Jr., the Move of God Ministries. Am I missing somebody? I see you pointing. Oh, my grandma, my 90-year-old granny, and Mrs. Odabel Willis. All right, well, we got to, and of course, Mr. Shedrick Daniels, he did all the certificates for you. Amen. Now, before you forget, inside of that package, there is a baseball card from Edwin Jackson. It is personally signed by him. The first five, he gave some shirts, but in the ones who don't have shirts in their bags, there's some goodies in there for you too. All right, Pastor Daddy, let's give them the benediction so they can eat and we can get out of Mr. Dave's house. Mr. Dave gave us a time constraint and we got to get up out of here. Let's give Mr. Dave a hand for letting us be in his house. And his staff. Thank you so much. Miss Kelly. And Nicole is not here, but Nicole helped buy some of the decorations too. Thank you, Wow.
Excuse me. We do thank God for what's done here today. And we can honestly say that's a foundation been laid. And there's a pathway sought for each one of these kids. And we thank God for the one, the builders of them. We thank God for Pam, Mr. Dave, and all the one involved, because I can't name, and I'm on time screen. Amen. But I got to wondering about that word. And what happened here today? We got a special service June the 7th at 4, and these special kids here, we need them in there. It's all right with the parents, amen, because if everybody could help me, we ask the blessing upon the food, the blessing upon what you're about to do, but it came in my heart, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Amen.
You ain't seen nothing yet. These kids are just like politicians. I'm scared to open my mouth in front of them. But glory to God. Pam, you haven't seen nothing yet.
Amen.
All these parents, you haven't seen nothing yet. Godly precepts is in here now. The pathway has been laid. And one word I need all of y'all to holler, and we can consider ourselves dismissed. And the food has been blessed. But that one word, as y'all can holler it out loud, with everything you got, and that word is, wow! Glory to God.